Hey everyone, today we're going to talk about a new feature that was recently released for Articulate Storyline that will save you a whole lot of time and a whole lot of triggers as well. So let's go ahead and get started. All right, welcome back. My name is Jeff Batts, and if you haven't checked out my website, go ahead and check out my website at learningdojo.ninja. Here you can check out all previous blog posts, everything covering Articulate, Storyline 360, and JavaScript, XAPI, just production tips and tricks, augmented reality, everything like that. You can also download free templates on Articulate, Storyline 360, and XAPI, and just production templates as well, strategy templates. And then if you're new, you can check out full courses, everything from A to Z, on Articulate, Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, XAPI Fundamentals, Articulate Rise, Custom SCORM, and HTML5 Video. Now this feature I am really excited for. It's going to save you a whole lot of time. I've been wanting this for a long time. It's going to save you a lot of triggers inside of Articulate Storyline. So to show you an example, I'm going to pull up this tab interaction right now. Now this tab interaction is a simple tab interaction, but I want to make sure they visit every single tab before it goes on to the next page. So right now, the way that I had to do this without this new feature that's been released is I had to create a layer that will show different text on every single layer. So you can see here, create layer and so forth. Then on the next button, what I'm doing is saying, okay, go ahead and jump to the next slide, but only if tab 1 is equal to visited, tab 2 is equal to visited, tab 3 is equal to visited, and tab 4 is equal to visited. So we'll not jump onto the next slide if all four of those have not been visited. Now that is a bad experience for the end user if they don't know that they have to complete all four tabs. And so if they try to click the next button without completing all four tabs, what I want to do is have this simple little layer show that will say, hey, you must complete all four tabs before moving on. This layer will show for 3 seconds, and then at the end of the timeline, it's going to hide. So it's just going to pop open on any tab, and then it's gonna go ahead and hide. Now on this gear icon, just so you know, I unchecked where it says hide other slide layers. That way if tab 4 is open, it's not going to hide tab 4, that text. It's going to show above tab 4 and then it's going to go away because it's only going to show, this layer is only going to show for a couple of seconds. Well, how do I show that layer? Coming back here, you couldn't have, okay, if it's not true, then do this. What you had to do is say, create a completely new trigger that said, okay, well, show the layer must complete, and you did this right after the next button, but show the layer must complete, which is right here, only if tab 1 is not equal to visited, or tab 2 is not equal to visited, or tab 4. So any one of those, if they're not visited, we're gonna show the must complete, which works. And so if I go ahead and preview this, let me show you. This is the kind of end experience that I wanted for the user. So I'm gonna go ahead and click on tab 1, I'm gonna click on next, and it's gonna show you must visit all four tabs. It's only gonna show for 3 seconds, and then it's going to go away. That's exactly what I wanted, but there is now a much more simple way to do this. So essentially what I'm going to do is delete this trigger of the show layer must complete. So I'm gonna go ahead and delete that, and I'm gonna keep this one. I still only want them to go on to the next page, only if all four of those tabs have been visited. And to do it based on the state, just so you know, you do have to have a visited state here. So I do have a visited state here, and that allows me to keep track if they've been visited or not. Instead of having a completely different trigger to say if any of those conditions are not true, if this does not run, then ignore that and don't do anything, we now have a different option. So I'm gonna go ahead and double click on this trigger here. And on this trigger, what I'm going to do is say, if any of these conditions are not true, we're going to do something else. And that is that keyword right there. If all of these are true, do this action. Else, meaning if any of those are not true, this condition does not get met, then run this. And it's gonna simplify things a whole lot more. So you can see right here, here's my condition. If go to the next slide, if tab 1 is visited and tab 2 and tab 3 and tab 4 are visited. Well, let's say that condition is not met. Then this is where the new section comes into play. So the new section is if any of those conditions or this condition is not met as a whole, because I'm using the word and, I'm kind of combining and saying that all these have to be true. If all those are not true, then what I'm going to do is go ahead and show the layer. And which layer am I going to show? Well, that's going to be the must complete. So just by adding this one little thing on top of this trigger, I've now reduced the amount of triggers that I need. Reducing the amount of triggers that you need inside of Articulate Storyline reduces the amount of code that needs to run. So let's go ahead and preview this, and we're going to get the same result as we did before. Just by simplifying it and getting rid of that extra trigger, not having to have all four of those conditions, we now have the same experience. So I'm going to go ahead and click on one of those, click on this, and there is my tab. It's going to show for 3 seconds. And then if I click on tab 3 and tab 4, now I can go on to the next slide. Huge time saver. I mean, this is something that I'm extremely excited about, and I wanted to show you at least an example of why it saves so much time and how you could apply it inside of your interaction. Just one example there. There's a lot more examples that we could explore, but just wanted to dive in and show you that. If you like this video, it's a huge help if you go to my YouTube channel, you click the like button, and you also subscribe to my channel and hit that bell notification so you get notified of all future videos that come out. You can also go to my website at learningdojo.ninja. You can check out all previous blog posts, as well as download the templates for Articulate Storyline 360 and XAPI. And then also, if you're new to any of these tools and you want to check out full training for it, you can check out training everything from A to Z on Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, XAPI Fundamentals, Articulate Rise, Custom SCORM, and HTML5 Video. That's all that I have for today. Hopefully that was useful for you and you're as excited as I am about this new feature inside of Articulate Storyline 360. I will see you next time. Thanks, everyone.